Now, to be able to start putting things into place, let's grab our master model and open that up again, just in its own window. I'll go to the right plane, create a sketch, zoom in here, and on this sketch, I'm going to grab my line tool, drop it down, and choose the center line. I'll create a center line that goes straight down the middle of this guy, right to the back, and that's going to serve as kind of the center axis of our model, right? So let's just exit that and leave it right as it is. I'll call this our, boom axis. And in fact, why don't I just drop it in the axes folder? Because it's just another axis that we need. And I don't know, are there any other things that we need? I guess right now, we don't need anything else. So let's close this back. We'll go back to our main assembly. And all I want to do is just kind of put this where it needs to be. So first of all, this 8-inch sub model, if it is fixed by any chance, if there's an F over here in the name, right-click it and go down to float. In my case, it's already floating. I can drag it around. It's ready to move. So I'm just going to mate this into place. So let's use this mounting bracket as our mating object. So I'll go to my mate tool. I'll grab the inner face of this mounting bracket and then click on that center axis. And by default, for me anyway, it's making it coincident. So you can see that the edge of that bracket is touching. It's coincident with that axis. But really what I want is for it to be concentric. So there we go. Now we have a speaker that is centered. Hit OK and OK. All right, that's fine. We'll go back to the right view. Zoom in here and drag this speaker on forward, because I think that's roughly where I want it, something right about there. And that's going to be a good starting point for us. I think that's about as far as we need to go for the moment. We can go ahead and start doing some surfacing.